Good afternoon. And welcome to this great wedding, this great celebration for Tyler and Hillary. Are you ready for this? Lindsay, did you bring them together?
Brothers and sisters, put on as God's chosen ones. God. And whatever you do, in word or in deed, do everything in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through Him. In the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Love that's an everyday life, it's a divine love. remember the words from St. Paul today. All being kind and just and well and fair. But most of all, it's got to be love. It's not what I get out of the marriage, but what I live in the marriage. Think about Jesus. Though you are both wonderfully made, and yet you have the opportunity to bring children into the world. Remember your eternal beings, that you're going to live forever. And whatever you bring into life will live forever also. Every child will live forever. And so it's your responsibility not only to make each other happy and be husband and wife, but it's also your job to make each other in heaven. I think people think about that in marriage. They think about, again, when I get out of the relationship. So this is not a private affair, it's a divine affair. Because we're divine beings. So live your life with that. Remember how Jesus loved us on the cross. Unconditionally. You need to love each other unconditionally. Even when it's not so fun to love each other unconditionally. Even though we didn't like it. None of us are perfect people. Everyone who's married in this church knows that not everything is like today. But they do it, they love each other. They make it work because they make it. Because they love each other. So I promise to take this woman, I promise to take this man for life. Even when times are tough. And Jesus says, if you come unto me, you will put me first, I'll get you through. That's when my sacrament appears. That's when you come with that type of love. It's not the love of the world talks about our beautiful songs. It's the love that's proud of God. So there needs to be three persons in this marriage. You two, God. Remember the commandments. It's first love of God and love of neighbor. Love God first. Love God first and love each other. Because if you love God first, God is real love. God is love. If you don't put God first, you will not have the love of the marriage that will make it work. Because God supplies that if you put God first. It sounds so simple, but it's not easy. So it's why it's important. We read this scripture. It's why it's important. God served the Holy Day. Why it says keep the Sabbath, go to the church, receive communion, worship. As we give praise to God, God's praise keeps my marriage together and our families together. So remember that. So when we need for each